Hi, Gemini. Today I'm excited to talk with you about the Capricorn full moon that occurs on July 21st. But we're going to be going back and forward quite a bit as a part of this discussion. This is a very interesting full moon. It's actually an astrological blue moon. We had a full moon in Capricorn a month ago on June 21st at the very beginning of the sign. And now on July 21st, we're having another full moon in Capricorn at 29 degrees. It means that we're really working in this house right now. There's a lot going on. And for you, this lunation, these lunations are occurring in your eighth house, Gemini. The eighth house rules a lot of different things. For example, it rules other people's money that has something to do with you. So, for example, a spouse's income can show up here, or inheritances. But the thing that it rules that I want to really focus on today, because we are talking about such a major transit with different things we'll be bringing into this reading, is transformation. The eighth house rules transformation. And again, because we're talking on such a major scale, I think that that is going to be relevant for you, Gemini. So, full moons are culmination points. They're times when our past efforts sort of come to fruition. We're able to see the results of our actions. And so, we're having two full moons in this house and sign back to back this summer. So, Gemini, for you, if you've been going through something of a transformation process, it might feel in some way that that's kind of coming to a head this summer. But let's get a little more information about this because it connects to a lot of other things in the chart as well. Since we're talking such big scale and there's such a profound interaction with these full moons, I want to talk about the nodes for a second. The nodes are where we have the eclipses, so in Aries and Libra, and the nodes take about a year and a half to move through a sign, and we really feel them. They help us to sort of let go of what isn't working anymore and bring in new energy. And they go for about a year and a half, and that's happening along an eclipse axis. So it tends to really be pretty heavy and pretty dramatic. It's something we can notice and feel in our lives. It's not subtle, or it's not as subtle as other things, for example. I think that things related to eclipses and lunations in astrology are the most obvious. So for you, this is happening in your fifth house and your 11th house. So you're letting go of what no longer serves you when it comes to fifth house areas. Things related to your creativity that aren't working anymore, or ways of relating with your children. The fifth house also rules children, so there could be some changes in those relationships. And you're bringing in a different 11th house theme era, where your North Node is located. And this is related to friends and groups. So, different people coming in, sort of in your public life, different groups that you associate with or friends. Social media is also ruled in the 11th house. So, anything related to social media or business that you do online can show up here as well. So, these lunations are interacting with those nodes as well. It's always good to keep in mind where the nodes are, I think. In astrology, it's a great thing to track. When you look back, you can really notice how during that year and a half period, there was a shift happening there. And these two full moons really are interacting with those nodes. So they may be a little bit potent at this time. This may be a good time to notice some shifts, or also just how your inner transformation is propelling and compelling this change. How is that helping you to let go of what's no longer serving you and bring in a new way of being in the 11th house with friends and groups? It's also interesting that the moon and the sun are at the 29th degree during this lunation. The sun is at 29 degrees of Cancer, and when the moon is at 29 degrees exactly, that's when there'll be this full moon. I relegated the chart so that we have Gemini in the first house here for you, Gemini. So this is just a tad before that full moon. We also have Neptune over here at 29 degrees of Pisces, and this is part of a much longer story, Gemini. Neptune is sort of hovering around this degree point for quite a while, another year or so, even longer. And this is connected to your career and your public image. There may be a real feeling of culmination there. The 29th degree is known as the critical degree or the culminating degree. Lessons are being learned. We're reflective. We're looking back. It's feeling like there are endings. But also, Neptune just kind of leaves us feeling a little confused sometimes. Like we don't quite know what's going on. So some things are definitely shifting, some things are ending, and that will make way for new and better things in the future. Not necessarily leaving a job or anything. It probably is more subtle than that, actually. It's probably more personal than that. It's more about who you are in terms of your career and your public image, how you see yourself, how you identify, especially as I'm tying it in with this lunation, connecting it to that theme of transformation. And I think the sun over in the second, which could pull on values a little bit, your values, what's most important to you, bringing in those themes to help you sort this all out. The sun sort of illuminates things. It shines light on it. So even though Neptune at 29 degrees can be a little confusing, you might feel like you don't know what's going on. There could be a little clarity around the time of the second Capricorn full moon on July 21st. And the 2 weeks that follow, you could have a little more insight about what that transformation concerning your career is really all about, or your public image. It's also interesting to note that when we have this kind of double lunation structure, it's what's known as a lunar reset. It resets the lunar cycle. So this again goes in about a year and a half periods where either we have the new moon first and then the full moon, or we have the full moon first and then the new moon. So this is during each astrological period, sun sign period. So when the sun enters Cancer, we either have a new moon after that or a full moon after that. And again, it goes in about a year and a half cycles. And it's so much more comfortable in the year and a half cycle that we're about to enter into than in the one that we're ending. Here's how I think of it. I think of new moon sort of as a meditation, right? They're a great time to go inward, to be quiet, to be contemplative, to make plans for the future. And a full moon is a party. Full moon is a great time to go out, be active, take action, see people, have conversations. So new moon is a meditation, full moon is a party. And from 2023 in March until July of 2024, we've had the party and then the meditation. And so it can always kind of feel like you're responding to something. You go to the party and then you have to come home and meditate and like reflect on what happened and take care of yourself. During that year and a half period, I think we can always feel a little bit like we're trying to catch up. But the cycle that we're entering into now, instead for a year and a half, we have the meditation and then the party. So you have that chance to sort of center and ground and be your best self and then go out into the world and take action. And it just tends to feel easier. I've really noticed this. It's something I've really felt when that shift occurs. So that's great news, sort of all around, maybe particularly where these different houses, these different areas of life are concerned for you, Gemini. Your inner transformation, your creativity, maybe your children, relationships with friends and groups, your career. But just in general, I think this lunar reset will just make things feel a little bit easier. Always good to have a meditation and then the party, not the other way around. Anyway, thank you so much for watching, Gemini. If you enjoyed this video, please like and subscribe to see more.